Okay, so today we're making a hyperlapse with the Mavic Pro, but this should be the exact same with all DJI drones. So first thing, go into your photo settings and choose interval. Today we're doing one photo every 2 seconds. I'll talk about why you might not want to have a longer interval in a little bit. Next, we're going to go to image ratio. Choose 16:9 since we're making a video. 4:3 is for photos. Image format, JPEG, only because with RAW we can only do one photo every 10 seconds. Next is white balance. Just make sure you're not on auto, otherwise the drone might change your white balance settings midway through the hyperlapse. Next, style. These are the settings I'm using right now. Check the description below for a little bit of more detail on these. D-log, because it doesn't add a lot of contrast. This gives us the most amount of room to work with in post to edit the photo how we want. Next, once you're in the air and you found the area that you want to take a hyperlapse of, go into one of the intelligent flight modes. Today we're using waypoints. This is pretty simple. Find the area that you want the hyperlapse to end and start recording waypoints. Record your first waypoint there. Then we're simply going to back up to where we want the hyperlapse to begin and record our next waypoint there. Then click done, then click apply. Now the drone is flying by itself as smoothly as possible, which is what we want since we're taking photos over a long period of time, which will be condensed into a very short video. I'm doing 2 miles per hour today because I find that 2 miles per hour with one photo every 2 seconds will give us a smooth sequence of photos, which Premiere with the warp stabilizer effect will be able to create a smooth piece of footage. Now you have to set your exposure. I'm going to choose about 1/50th of a second right now because I'm using an ND filter. Of course, make sure you're using the lowest ISO possible, which during the daytime will most likely be 100. And don't forget to set your focus. Once you've done that, you'll be ready to click the shutter button to begin taking the photos. If you want to do some math and figure out how long the flight will take so you know how much battery you'll need or how much footage you'll get from the set of pictures, you might want to set your drone to use the metric system. For example, you could have a flight path of 200 meters and fly at 1 meter per second. You know that that flight will take 200 seconds to complete and you'll get 100 photos from that flight if you're taking one photo every 2 seconds. And if you're making a video that's going to play at 24 frames per second, you'll know you'll get about 4 seconds of footage from those 100 pictures. So now we're going to import all the photos we just took into Lightroom and begin editing, but we only have to edit one photo. So I'm going to apply a preset here, make a few other changes, and then I'm going to sync these edits across all my photos by selecting the photo that I just edited, then holding down Ctrl A to select all the photos. Then I'm going to go over and click sync. Once I've reviewed that all the settings are going to be synced, I click synchronize, and as you can see, it's going to play all these changes to all of the photos. Next, we're going to create a folder on the desktop just for this video. We're going to call it Hyperlapse. Then we're going to find this folder in our export settings and export the photos to there. Also, instead of having your photos named DJI 0256, 0257, etc., and so on, we're going to have a custom naming sequence. So just copy my settings here so your pictures will be named starting off with the number 1 and go in order up from there. Now, just open up a new project in Premiere Pro. We'll call this one Short Hyperlapse, and then we're going to import this sequence. Now, go to import, find that folder that we just created onto the desktop, and we're going to click just the first photo, and then important here, make sure you click Image Sequence. Premiere will now magically create a video from your photo sequence. You don't have to do anything. But as we can tell, it's a little bit shaky as usual, so we're going to drag this clip onto our timeline, then go over to the effects and put on the warp stabilizer. Another thing you can do is hold down the Alt key and drag this clip over to the right to copy it, then change the settings to play it in reverse. So now I'll show you a few examples of what can go wrong if you fly too fast or take your pictures too far spaced apart. In this first clip, I'm flying at 4 miles per hour and taking a photo once every 2 seconds. As you can tell, Premiere with the warp stabilizer just can't make sense of the photos and the footage is pretty shaky. The next clip here, I'm flying at 2 miles per hour, but I'm taking a photo once every 5 seconds. And again, it's shaky. Maybe if the wind wasn't so bad, we'd have a different story. This next clip, I'm flying at 12 miles per hour, taking a photo once every 2 seconds, and I have a 1 second shutter speed. It's pretty blurry, so you might think, let's decrease the shutter speed, but I have the same 1 second shutter speed in this clip, but I'm only flying at 2 miles per hour. So I'm going to be coming out with sort of a part two version of this tutorial where I go into some more advanced hyperlapse techniques, show you some cool effects to make your footage even more exciting. If you want to see that, please like this video and subscribe. Also, if you have any questions about this video, just leave them in the comments and I'll get back to them as soon as I can. Thanks for watching.